Our annual cultural parade is a symbol of unity amongst the provincial government, the national government agencies, municipal local government units, different private sectors, and all the stakeholders towards the Batanes of a progressive people. Approaching now the Aquino Grandstand are our color guards carrying our Philippine national flag and the provincial emblem. And now, approaching our grandstand is the strong men and women of the Philippine National Police, headed by the Provincial Director, Police Colonel Emil A. Tumibay, PMP. Approaching the grand side, the strong platoon of the Philippine Coast Guard, headed by Lieutenant Junior Graham Johnson, San Juan, PCG. Thank you. approaching to Grand Slam, the Department of Agriculture, Batangas Experimental Station, or DAVES, headed by Center Chief Dr. Richard Patayuma. Let's all give up to the DAVES men and women. Following DAVES and approaching our Grand Slam is the personnel and officials of the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources, or FAR, headed by their own provincial director, Madam Rich Rivera. Following before are the employees of the National Food Authority, with their officer in charge, Ms. Jehan Hetsha. Request Ms. Jehan Hetsha to be here at the Grand Stand. And now approaching the Grand Stand are the employees of the Department of Agrarian Reform, with their officer in charge, Ms. Jocelyn Flores. As such, we request also Ms. Jocelyn to be here at the Grand Stand. Thank you very much, Dar. And now our province payroll partner for cashless transactions and Easter fund transfer, ladies and gentlemen, the men and women of the Land Bank of the Philippines, headed by their own active manager, Mr. Joseph Caligula. Let Land Bank help you grow. Thank you. once again, the men and women of the Department of Public Works and Highways. Approaching the grandstand, ang ating mga taga-protekta ng ating kalikasan at kasayaman, the men and women of the Department of Environment and Natural Resources, headed by the Provincial Director, Ms. Victoria Baliwa. Following them are the employees of the DNR Environmental Management Bureau, headed by Mr. Edson Lopez. And following them is the Provincial Science and Technology Center of Batanes, headed by Provincial Director Ms. Nora Garcia. PSTC Batanes is the provincial office of the DOST, responsible for technology transfer and commercialization of resource-based products. Through them, we bring science and technology innovations closer to the Batanes. Approaching the grandstand are the men and women of the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines, or CAA, headed by the OIC Airport Manager, Ms. Louie Asantor.
Thank you.
Maraming salamat. alone, DOH retained the hospital in the province of Batanes. The Batanes General Hospital, headed by Dr. Jeffrey Anthony T. Manserai. Narito po ang karamihan sa kanilang mga medical personnel, kaya sana po ay wala maling disgrasya ngayong araw para wala pong papunta sa ating ICU. Andito po lahat ng kanilang mga empleyado, walang paan po natin ang PGH. So pwede na pong tumama sa mga pasyente sa PGH.
Yeah.
Caesar. From the provincial government of Batanes, maraming salamat sa lahat ng ating mga guro at kawani ng DepEd-SDO Batanes. Mabuhay! Here in front of the grandstand is the Mr. and Miss SDO of the Basco Schools. Approaching the grandstand are our very handsome Mr. BNSHS and the very beautiful Miss BNSHS. Of course, followed by the teachers and personnel of the Batanes National Science High School.
Thank you.
Uyugan Schools. Once again, maraming maraming salamat sa lahat ng kawani at guro ng Department of Education. Following the death ed, are the officers and employees of the National Power Corporation headed by Engineer Ernesto O. Rosas Jr.
Thank you.
Once again, maraming salamat, BNSHS Drum and Largo. Approaching now the Grand Star, the faculty and staff of the Batanas State College, the BSC, headed by the Officer in Charge, Attorney Marcos Cerro Domingo.
Appreciation to our partners of life.
under kampanya ng kapatid Kiso Chile at Bataan. Diyos matahas, BCCI at numbers. And here in front of the grand snag at the Basco Central School, drum and cardboard.
Thank you.
to our tour guides.
Hey! Woo! Hey! Woo!
Following our tour guides association, approaching the grandstand are the members of the Batanes Homestay Association, headed by their president, Ms. Felicia Gatti. Just from us to our Bahomas. And approaching our stage are the members of the Batanes Massage Therapist Association with their president, Ms. Melanie Valiente. Of the Cormac Tricycle Association, headed by their president, Mr. Felix. Maraming maraming salamat sa ating tourism stakeholders at kalaki ang mga bagay lalo-lalo po sa ating pagbubukas ng tourism. Diyos mamahas, inyong ataw. Thank you. Please welcome us to our kahilians from Big Bayan. We have also here in front of the grandstand the Sabdang Senior Citizens. Maraming salamat po, Sabdang Senior Citizens. Meron pong naka-assign na one sa inyo dyan sa mga collapsible tents. So once again, we'd like to remind everyone na ating pong collapsible tents ay designated po para sa ating mga senior citizens. We have here in front of the grandstand the delegation of the municipality of Sabdang. Pero at ako kay Diyan, ibon Sabdang, Diyos mamahals. Headed by the municipal mayor, Marshal Armando Alabado. Officials, the Sabdang farmers and fishermen, kahalakan ng Sabdang, Sabdang senior citizens, and the Sabdang community. Ladies and gentlemen, approaching the grand star from the Yala municipality, the delegation of Imana, headed by their very active mayor, Honorable Leonardo Ostaliello. I request the Honorable Mayor here at the grand star. Just for my to the municipal and barangay officials of Imana, including the Imana farmers and fishermen, kahilakan ng Imana, Imana senior citizens, and the Imana community in general. Mabuhay! Our grandstand is the delegation of the municipality of Mahatao, headed by their municipal mayor, Honorable Pedro F. Poncho. We have here officials of the Mahatao municipal government and all the barangay units, including the Mahatao farmers and fishermen, kahinakan ng Mahatao, Mahatao senior citizens, and the Mahatao community at large. Just mahal sa buhay, bayan ng Mahatao. Thank you. citizens, headed by Ms. Agnes Vinas. Diyos mamahas to our Basco senior citizens. Meron pong naka-assign o buwan para sa inyo dyan po sa ating mga buhay at kolapsi po tenants. Gentlemen, approaching the grandstand from the Blue District, the delegation of the municipality of Buyugan, headed by our very youthful mayor, Honorable Jonathan Enrique Vina Jr. We have here the Buyugan municipal and barangay officials, the Buyugan farmers and fishermen, kahitakan ng Buyugan, Buyugan senior citizens, and the Buyugan community at large. The colors prepared for the attire are white, which was based on the cotton fiber prevalent during the early days, blue representing the Dibang, and amber depicting the Buridaw that we mostly use to give colors our walls and pattern. The blue and amber are also the colors of the prominent coral beads, the Mudag, and the Mutin accessory. The pattern of the edge designs of the attires were based on the design pattern seen on pottery shards excavated from various archaeological sites in Batanes. Our handsome and beautiful models of the proposed attires are Mr. SDO 2022 Mr. Edward Valiente, Ms. SDO 2022 Ms. Don Valiente, Ms. Dos Rice Batanes, Ms. Michelle Ann Cabugao, and one of our artisans, Ms. Diane Valles. Mr. SDO is wearing a white vest inspired by the kadukad that men usually wear during special events. This is complemented by an anud necklace. In the early days, the kadukad was usually paired with palijit necklace and pinatapatan gold earring.
Miss SBO is wearing an upper white kimono and a blue overlapping skirt featuring the Burda design pattern. She is wearing the Namut beadworks for single women, which is a blue and white headband and a choker. Miss Dosrice Batanes 2022 is modeling the same design but made of the hand-woven pinon and hand-woven belt called tahud. She is adorned by one of our precious gold ornaments, the Bumbulya earrings. Our artisan, Miss Balies, is wearing a Buridaw highlighted hula dress, as signified by her accessories. She is representing here a married Ibatan woman or a woman in higher position, with a headdress accessory that covers both sides of her face, kadas on both legs, and a bead bracelet. This attire for social events is up for endorsement by the provincial governor to the Sangguniang Panlalawigan for adoption.
And now approaching the grandstand are the men and women from the provincial government of Batanes. At nangunguna po ang ating mga empleyado mula sa provincial accounting office. The Provincial Budget Office, care of Mr. Serafin Valiente. The Provincial Treasury Office, care of Mr. Juanito Abengaña. We have here from the Provincial Planning and Development Office, care of Ms. Marisa Antonio. From the Provincial Officer's Office, headed by Ms. Doris C. Ruiz. From the Provincial Agriculturist Office, with our Provincial Agriculturist, Mr. Cesar Dorateo Costalier. Provincial Veterinary Office, headed by Dr. Orea V. Perez. Following them are our Provincial Human Resource Management and Development Office, together with Batanes Technical Skills Development Center and the Public Employment Service Office, headed by our PHMRDO, Ms. Ana Marie A. Rosas. Following them are the employees of the Provincial Social Welfare and Development with their boss, Mr. Henry C. Cone. We have here the men and women from the Provincial Engineering Office headed by Engineer Mark Hilario Ventolero. Approaching the grandstand are frontliners from the Provincial Health Office, headed by our Provincial Health Officer, Dr. Alan Sande. Is this some of us, our PHO? Following them are the employees of the Provincial General Services Office under the leadership of the concurrent GSO, Ms. Ana Marie A. Rosas. Following our GSO are the employees from the Office of the Secretary of the Sangguniang Panlalawigan, headed by Mr. Anthony De Los Santos.